In this video, we are going to talk about biggest lottery winners. Where are they now? So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to our channel for the future updates. Most of us believe that all lottery winners live happily ever after, but for many of them, this is simply not the case. The biggest jackpot winners are still average people, despite having hundreds of millions at their disposal. That implies they, like the rest of us, have their own difficulties to cope with. Winning the lotto wasn't always the golden ticket that many of these people had hoped for. Some people may have had greater luck than others, but these examples show that having a lot of money doesn't make you immune to life's difficulties. Here's a list of the biggest lottery winners. Where are they now? Let's start. Number 10. Cindy and Mark Hill, $136.5 million. Cindy and Mark Hill have kept their humble lifestyles, donating the majority of their earnings to civic projects and charity activities in their hometown of Missouri. Cindy and Mark Hill split the $587.5 million Powerball prize in November 2012. The Hills, like Maureen Smith and David Kaltschmidt, have continued to live modestly since their victory. He's also passed on the Camaro sports car he had his eye on in favor of a humble pickup truck. That isn't to say the Hills haven't put their winnings to good use. The Hills had already donated to civic projects in their hometown of Camden Point, Missouri, before winning the Powerball jackpot. The Hills' generosity appears to have risen tenfold now that they have millions in Powerball prizes. Number 9. Gloria McKenzie, $278 million. Gloria McKenzie built a coastal mansion in place of her shabby apartment and gave $2 million to restore a Maine high school. Gloria McKenzie, an 84-year-old from Zephyr Hills, Florida, won the $590.5 million jackpot in May 2013 with no one else to share it with. McKenzie brought home a tidy $278 million after taxes as the lone winner. Following her big win, McKenzie upgraded to a $1.2 million beachside estate in Jacksonville, Florida, from her rundown $30,000 rental unit. McKenzie also gave a $2 million donation to a Maine high school in need of new roofs. The benevolent grandmother also promised to split her prize money with her son, Scott. What is the current status of the Powerball winner? It's difficult to say because her family has sought privacy and there has been no update since. Number 8. Laren West, $343.8 million. Laren West, a single mother from Iowa, is clearly reaping the benefits of her good fortune, both financially and through charity contributions to various organizations. Laren West resigned her job in the insurance industry after winning the lottery and founded her own company. The next day, she appeared on The Ellen DeGeneres Show, where she announced that she will make a $500,000 donation to the Travis Mills Foundation in memory of her son. West established the Callum Foundation in honor of her grandson, Callum. With the support of her family and a recently hired money manager, she was able to do this. The nonprofit foundation helps organizations that aim to improve children's education, health, animal welfare, and veterans' welfare, among other things. Number 7. Robert Bailey, $343.8 million. Robert Bailey appears to have maintained to his aim of being prudent with his newly acquired fortune. There has been very little information regarding his current situation, which is usually a good indicator in the world of lottery winners. Robert Bailey of New York won half of the $687.8 million Powerball jackpot on October 27, 2018. After federal and state taxes, he took home over $125 million. Bailey announced in a news conference after accepting his award that he had recruited a lawyer and a financial advisor to help him navigate his new life as a millionaire. Bailey claimed that the lucky combination he utilized to win the jackpot had been one he had been playing for over 25 years. He then stated that even after his great win, he would continue to play the same numbers. Number 6. Mavis Wanchuk, $336 million. Mavis Wanchuk resigned from her job and disappeared from public view. Wanchuk stated when she accepted her reward that she wanted to be alone and figure out what she wanted to do next, and it appears that she did just that. Mavis Wanchuk was the single winner of the U.S. Powerball draw on August 27, 2017. The 50-year-old mother from Massachusetts took home a lump payment of $336,350,655 after taxes because she had no one to split the award. Number 5. Manuel Franco, $326 million. There has been no official news on Manuel Franco's whereabouts or current health condition since he came up to claim his medal more than a year ago. On April 23, 2019, an unidentified Milwaukee resident by the name of Manuel Franco came forward to collect the state's third-largest lottery jackpot in state history. Franco grew up as a son and with his father, who is a retired teacher. The settlement was agreed in a single lump sum of $477 million, of which he will receive roughly $326 million after taxes as compensation. Number 4. Marvin and May Acosta, $327.8 million. Before winning their jackpot, the Acostas were deafeningly quiet, and they've maintained that silence ever since. Scammers have attempted to take advantage of the Acosta's charitable initiatives, so we can only presume they have chosen to keep their giving private. The final third of 2016's $1.58 billion Powerball jackpot winners, Marvin and May Acosta, have been silent since their big win. It's not surprising, given that the couple hid for over 6 months before claiming their prize. The Acostas continue to maintain a low profile nowadays. Their decision to keep out of the spotlight appears to have paid off. As soon as they announced their plans to start a charity, scammers pounced. Number 3. Maureen Smith and David Kaltschmidt, $327.8 million. Maureen Smith and David Kaltschmidt, both in their 80s, continue to buy lottery tickets. The pair has stuck to their usual habits and routines, with the exception of a few luxury purchases. The Smiths and Kaltschmidts, on the other hand, have maintained a modest lifestyle after winning the Powerball jackpot, in contrast to the Robinsons. They haven't spent a single penny of their inheritance so far, with the exception of a $90,000 Tesla and a new SUV. Despite this, he and his wife remain in their $400,000 Florida house, which also serves as the headquarters for one of the country's largest state lottery operations. These people continue to shop at the same stores and eat at the same restaurants. Aside from that, individuals continue about their regular lives as if nothing significant had occurred in the previous 24 hours. The pair continues to play the Powerball despite winning a lump payment of $327.8 million before taxes. Number 2. John and Lisa Robinson, $327.8 million. John and Lisa Robinson have upgraded to a multi-million dollar property with a home theater and a private lake since winning the Powerball. They've stayed out of the news except for the notable mansion. On January 13, 2016, John and Lisa Robinson were the lucky winners of a share of the $1.58 billion Powerball prize. The couple decided to keep their humble Munford, Tennessee house despite their unexpected wealth. "These large luxury houses are lovely, but you must clean them," John said. Lisa, on the other hand, stated that she intended to continue working. Their magnificent property, which sits on a 320-acre lot and features a private lake and some of Tennessee's best views, is situated on a 320-acre lot. It also includes 8 bathrooms and a well-equipped home theater. So much for living in a little house. Number 1. Anonymous winner from North Carolina, $1.537 billion. Only a year ago, the winner of the country's largest lottery jackpot came forward to claim his award. Because the enigmatic winner only communicates with the public through a legal agent, everyone is mystified as to who he or she is. This looks to be an appropriate conclusion after more examination. The winner may choose between two possibilities, depending on his or her preferences: withdrawing the entire prize money or receiving lesser payments over the next 30 years, which would still represent huge sums of money each year. The fortunate individual chose the first of the two possibilities offered to him. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button for the channel now trending before you go. Thanks for watching.